Good morning, students. Let's learn today exercise 16. In that, question number 6. See, I will read the question. You just keep your finger on that. 14 books cost rupees 259. What is given? First, let's write given. Okay. Given. 14 books cost. 14 books cost. How much it is? Rupees 259. 14 books cost rupees 259. Find the cost of a dozen of such books. What it is given? 14 books cost rupees 259. And what it is given? Find the cost of a dozen of books. Okay. Cost of a dozen of books. So, a dozen of book cost how much? A dozen of books cost how much? Okay. This is the short I have written and given. 14 books cost is rupees 259. Then find the cost of a dozen of books. Okay. Find the cost of a dozen of books. Okay. So, what we have to do here? See, a dozen of book means one dozen book. In one dozen, how many things are there? 12 things. Okay. A dozen. A dozen means 12. 12 things. Means 12 books. Now here it is given about books. So 12 books. A dozen means 12 books. Means it is given about 14 books cost is given and it has asked to find the 12 books cost. Given for 14 books cost and it is asked to find the 12 book cost. So to find the 12 book cost, first we should know the cost of one book. Okay. See, 14 books cost rupees 259. Then one book cost is equal to how much? 14 book cost is equal to rupees 259. Then one book cost is equal to how much rupees? Why? Now you will say here, madam, it is not asked for one book cost. Why you are finding one book cost? Because we have to find for 12 books. Now for that we should know first one book cost. Then only we can find the 12 book cost. Okay. So here we need to find the cost of one book first. Okay. So to find the cost of one book, we need to divide for 259 rupees. We have to divide by 14. Okay. So let's divide. See here I will rub this because I will not get pressed down to show the division. Okay. So, for 259, so what we have to find? Cost of one book. One book, what it is asked to find the cost of dozen. So, cost of one book is equal to cost of one book is equal to 259 rupees divided by 14. Okay, what we have to do? 250. For 259 rupees, we will divide by 14. Okay, so 259 rupees given. Okay, 259 rupees. Okay, so you know 259 rupees. Okay, rupees 259. And paise, paise given? No. But we will write here paise also. What paise will write? 0, 0. 259 rupees, 0, 0 paise. Means 259 rupees only because it may come the cost of one book is in rupees or rupees and paise. So first only we have to write here this amount in rupees and paise. See, 259 rupees and 0, 0 paise means only 259 rupees. Okay, so let's divide for these rupees by 14. Okay. So do this division. Understood why I have written here 0, 0. It may get the value in rupees and paise. So this amount we have to write in the rupees and paise. So I have to write in rupees and paise 259 rupees and we have to give real decimal point and 00 paise means after this point these are paise. Okay, so now divide. Here write rupees because we are going to get the value of one book, that is in rupees. So write here rupees first. 14 ones are 14. Okay, 5 minus 4 1 2 minus 1 1. Now 9 will come down. 14 8s are 112. 14 8s are 112. Everyone knows the table. 14 8s are 112. 9 minus 2 7. 1 minus 1 0. 1 minus 1 0. Okay, now this decimal point, now we do not have to take this decimal point down. See, this we got here remainder 7. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to take this 0 down, but before that here decimal point is given, so here also we have to give the decimal point. Okay, we are going to take now paise down, na 0 paise down. So here we have to write point. Now take this 0 down. Okay, 14 5s are 70. Okay, 14 5s are 70. Okay, now 0 minus 0 0. 7 minus 7 0. Now 0 will come down. So 14 0s are 0. Okay, so what we got the value for, what we got cost of one book, cost of one book we got 18 rupees 50 paise. Cost of one book, how much we got? Cost of one book we got 18 rupees 50 paise. So right here, cost of one book is rupees 18 and 50 paise. Now one thing is asked to find the dozen of books cost. Find the cost of a dozen of books. A dozen means 12 books cost we have to find. So cost of 12 books is equal to how much? 12 books I have written, it is asked a dozen books. A dozen means 1 dozen. 1 dozen means 12. Okay. Cost of 1 book is 18 rupees 50 paise. Then we have to find the cost of 12 books. Okay. 12 books. Now it is given for 1 and asking for many. So we need to multiply. Okay. So for these rupees 18 and 50 paise, we have to multiply by 12. Now see, while doing multiplication, see, of this decimal, don't think for this decimal point. Do as a simple multiplication first. You know to do without decimal point, you are doing multiplication in the same way. We have to multiply first and then we have to shift the decimal point. Okay. So 12 zeros are 0. 12 fives are 60. So 0 will come here. 6 will be the carry. Okay. 12 8s are 96. 12 8s are 96. 96 plus 6, 102. So here will come 2 and 10 will be the carry. 12 ones are 12. 12 plus 10. 12 plus 10. 22. So how much you got? See, now cancel this carries. Now see, like simple multiplication I have done. Now see here, after decimal point here 2 digits are given. Here after decimal point 2 digits. So here count the 2 digits from right towards left. Here 1, 2. 2 digits, so 1, 2. Here give the decimal point. So what you got? Rupees 222 and 0, 0 paise. Means how much amount you got? Rupees 222. So the cost of a dozen of book is rupees 222. Okay. So what you will write? Write this afterwards in sentence. Cost of a dozen of books is rupees 222. See question number 7. 16 packets of biscuits cost rupees 40. So let's write first given. Okay. 6 given. What is given? 16 packets of biscuit. 16 packets of biscuit cost rupees 40. Okay, how much it is? Rupees 40. 16 packets of biscuits cost rupees 40. And what it is asked? Ashok bought. What it is given? Ashok bought 2 dozen such a packet. What should he pay for them? How much dozen packet he bought? 2 dozen. 2 dozen means, see, 1 dozen means 12. Then 2 dozen means 24 packets he bought. So we have to find the cost of 24 packets. Okay. 16 packets of biscuits cost rupees 40. And Ashok bought 2 dozen such a packet. So what should pay for them? Is what we have to. How much amount should we pay for 2 dozen of packet? Okay. So 16 packets cost is given rupees 40. So first what we need to find? Cost one packet. Cost of one biscuit packet. Okay. So one packet of biscuit cost we have to find. Okay. So one packet of biscuit. One packet of biscuit cost. Now 16 packets of biscuits cost is rupees 40, and we have to find for one packet of biscuits cost. So we need to divide by 16. Okay, for 40 rupees we have to divide by 16. So one packet of biscuits cost is, well, how we have to find for 40 rupees we have to divide by 60. See here, 40 rupees. For rupees 40, we have to divide by 16. Okay. 16 ones are 60. 16 twos are 32. Okay. 16 twos are 32. Now here we will write first rupees, because this amount is in rupees. So rupees. 16 twos are 32. Okay. So now 0 minus 2 is possible. No, so take borrow. If you will take borrow, how much will remain here? Here will remain 3. So 10 minus 2, 8. 10 minus 2, 8. 3 minus 3, 0. Okay, now left, how much it is left here? 8. Okay, means now we have to give here decimal point. See, this amount is in rupees, but something paise also we have to pay. Okay, all the things we are not getting, only rupees amount is there. Means this pencil is there for 3 rupees 50 paise. Similarly here also, so we have to give here decimal point. After decimal point we have to write here our own zero. Okay, and now take this zero down, 16. Okay, now here we have given decimal point, so here also we have to give decimal point. See here, again I will repeat this. See here we got 8, okay, remainder is 8, so means something amount is in paise also. So paise also, so after rupees we have to give here decimal point. We have to write here 0, okay, we have to write here 0. See, paise, after decimal point there are 2 digits for paise, so you can write here 2 zeros also, no problem. Okay, to understand rupees and paise, paise always we are writing in 2 digits. Okay, so here write 2 zeros. Okay, so now see, decimal point we have given, so here also we have to give the decimal point. When we give the decimal point here, at the same time we have to give here also, and then take this number down. Okay, now 16 fives are 80. 16 fives are 80. Now 0 minus 0 0. 8 minus 8 0. Now you can take this number down. Okay, 16 zeros are 0. So what you got answer? Rupees 2 and 50 paise. If you will not give this 0, even though okay, paise we are writing in 2 digits, so we have to write here 0, our own 0. For your understanding, I have given 0 here. See, rupees 40. Rupees 40 dot 0, 0 paise we are writing or not? We are writing or not? Same way we have to write here. Okay, so rupees 2 and 50 paise we got. So 1 packet of biscuit cost is, so 1 packet of biscuit cost is rupees 2 and 50 paise. 2 rupees and 50 paise. Okay, so what it is asked? Ashok bought 2 dozen such a packet. So what we have to find? 2 dozen packets cost is equal to how much? 1 packet of biscuits cost is rupees 2 and 50 paise. Then 2 dozen packets cost is how much? So see, 2 dozen means how many things? 24. 1 dozen means 12. So 2 dozen means 24 packets. Now here will come 24 packets. 2 dozen means 24 packets. See, here I have written 2 dozen means 24 packets. Now these all the things it has taught. 1 dozen means how much? 2 dozen means how much? 1 dozen means 12. Means then 2 dozen means 24 packets. First we have to find. 1 packet cost is 2 rupees 50 paise. Then 24 packets cost is how much? So we need to multiply. Okay, so 2 rupees 50 paise, for 2 rupees 50 paise if we will multiply by 24. See, if you don't know the table, you can do like a simple. See, 4 zeros are 0, 4 fives are 20, 2 carry, okay. 4 twos are 8 and 2, 10. Don't think for this decimal point, okay. Don't think for this decimal point first. First solve like a simple multiplication. Simple multiplication you know to solve. Don't think for this. This, when we have to think for decimal point, after getting final answer, we have to see the decimal point and we have to shift that much digit. Okay. So now for this carry, right here plus 0. 2 zeros are 0, 2 fives are 10, 1 is carry, 2 twos are 4 and 1, 5. Okay. 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 0, 0, 1 plus 5, 6. Okay, so what we got? 6000 we got. Okay, now see, here it is, after decimal point 2 digits are there. After decimal point here 2 digits are given. So from right hand side count 2 digits and give your decimal point. 1, 2. 2 digits and give the decimal point. So how much we got? Rupees 60 and 00 paise means rupees 60 only. Okay. So what it is asked? What should he pay for them? He should pay rupees 60 for 24 packets. What is the answer? He should pay rupees 60 for 24 packets. Let's solve question number 8. A servant was engaged on an annual salary of rupees 2700. Okay, servant was engaged on an annual salary. Annual salary means yearly salary. Annual salary, see, underline the word annual salary, means whole year salary. How much it is given? 2700 rupees. Okay, whole year salary 2700 rupees. But due to some family problem, he left the service after 8 months. Okay, he left the service after 8 months. So how much salary should he receive? See, after saying, you will say here given about annual salary and now he left the service how for 8 months, after 8 months, then how much salary should he receive? It's very difficult to find. It's not difficult. See, annual salary, and annual salary means whole year salary, and it is given for 8 months. 1 year means how many months? 12 months. So 12 months salary is given. So what is given? See, I am writing it short. Given 12 months salary. Now you will say, madam, here it is not given 12 months salary. Annual salary is given or not? Annual means whole year. In whole year, how many months are there? 12 months. Now you will say, madam, but why we have writing month only? Because see, if you will read whole example, see, it is given, he left the service after 8 months. Means it is given in months. So we need to write this in month. So we need to write annual salary in months. So 12 months salary, how much it is? Is rupees 2700. 12 months salary is rupees 2700. But due to some family problems, he left the service after 8 months. Okay, means it was decided for his whole year salary. For whole year salary, he is going to get 2700 rupees. But he has not done the service for whole year. He left after 8 months due to some family problems. Okay. So I have written this salary in month. Whole year salary. Whole year means 12 month. 12 month salary is 2700 rupees. And we have to find his salary for 8 months. So first we should note the salary of 1 month. So let's find 1 month salary is how much. So 1 month salary for 1 month salary, what we have to do? We have to divide for rupees 2700 divided by 12. Okay, if we will divide 1 month salary, how we will find? See, 12 month salary is 2700 and we have to find 1 month salary. It is 1 month salary. So for that we need to divide. So divide for 2700 by 12. Okay. So here I am doing division. These are rupees. Okay. So divide by 12. 12 2s are 24. Division everyone knows, the 7 minus 4, 3, 2 minus 2, 0. Okay. 12, 2s are 24. Okay, 12, 2s are 24. See, here you can write rupees. It is given in rupees, na? So write rupees. 12, 2s are 24. 0 minus 4 is not possible, so take borrow here. We will get 10. 10 minus 4, 6. Here will remain 2. 2 minus 2, 0. Okay, now let's take 0 down. 12 5s are 60. 12 5s are 60. Okay, so what we got here? 1 month salary, how much we got? 225 rupees. So, 1 month salary is rupees 225. Okay, 225 rupees. Okay, so what it is asked now? But due to some family problem, he left the service after 8 months. So how much salary should he receive? Okay, he left after 8 months, means he worked for only 8 months. So 1 month salary we know now. 1 month salary we got rupees 225. Okay, 1 month salary is equal to rupees 225 and he left the job after 8 months. So we have to find the 8 month salary. So 8 months salary is equal to how much? Okay, now it is, we know the salary of 1 month. Now we have to find for 8 months. So we need to multiply. So do the multiplication here. 225 multiplied by 8. Okay. So 8 5s are 40. 8 2s are 16. 16 plus 4, 20. Okay. So 2 will be the carry. 8 2s are 16. 16 plus 2, 18. Okay. So what we got? See, these are rupees. Rupees 225. So how much we got? Rupees 1800. So what is 8 months salary? Rupees 1800. His 8 months salary is rupees 1800. You can write this. He received rupees 1,800. His 8 months salary is rupees 1,800.